Okay, so in the previous Colab, I talked about all the sort of beginner stuff. In this one, I'm going to go into some more advanced tips and some things that you probably should check out if you're going to be using Colab quite regularly. So the first one is one, just to make sure that everyone got this, is one that I talked about in the previous lesson, and that's secrets. So just make sure you know how to set up secrets. So you're setting up your environment variables and you can store these in here and then use them going forward. If you're not sure how to do that, go back and watch that. I went through that at the end of the beginner's course in there. And this is something that's quite recent to Colab. So even if you've been using Colab for a while, you may not have seen this before. The next one up that I want to talk about is the whole idea of snippets. So if I come in here and I've got a new Colab, right? And let's say I want to basically build something where I'm going to have a Hugging Face model in here. What I can come down here is click into snippets, and I can basically just say, so I've been getting this set up. I can come in here and just say, basically say, okay, transformers. And I can see that, okay, transformers LLM test. I can click to add that and then insert that, close out the snippet. And you'll see that now I've basically got some empty stuff at the top, which I can delete. But now I've got a setup for loading up transformers, the latest version from GitHub. I've got checking the NVIDIA GPU in here. I've got an example of bringing in one of the Hugging Face models. In this case, it's the Mistral Zephyr model. But that's going to be very easy to change. And I've also got the whole sort of setup for basically setting up as a pipeline, my text wrap function in here, my generate function in here for doing this. And then I've got an example of calling that. So all of this code just magically appears. So how does that happen? If you come into snippets, you've got a whole bunch of snippets that Google gives you. And a lot of those are things like connecting to Gemini, camera capture, these kind of things. But you can make your own. So how do you make your own? So if you come up here and you go to settings, in here, you'll see that you can basically set a custom snippet notebook URL. So you can basically just copy one of your Colabs over and make that a set of snippets. So let me sort of walk you through this and you can see, you know, what I've got here. So I've got like this whole thing here for using different libraries. If I want to use pandas, if I want to use TensorFlow, if I want to bring in different data sets that I used to use a lot with confusion matrix. All these kind of things I can just bring in and use them straight out of the box. So here, for example, if I want to get just a simple Flax or Jax setup, I can just come in and basically do that. If I want to do something more sort of LangChain, here you can see the LangChain Anthropic setup. So I've got my standard sort of setup using the Anthropic keys. I can bring it in. I've got it set up for each of the different models. So it's quite easy for me to go through it and change that. If I want to do it for OpenAI, I can do that here. If I want to do a LangGraph or different sorts of setups, I can do this here. So setting up snippets is something that will really help you to basically just get better results out of whatever it is that you're doing. So this is a really simple thing that you can do, but very quickly you can just have it so that, you know, for me, the whole idea of Colab and the thing that makes Colab really good is just very quickly, I can go from idea to some working code. That's the goal for me, right? How quickly can I get to some working code to try out an idea, whether that's building an agent, whether that's testing out a new model, something like that. How quickly can I get it up, get it running, see, you know, how well this is going to work? And then I can focus on maybe fixing up the code or changing some things here and there. So to do this, snippets is just such a useful tool here for a whole bunch of different things, both for local kind of stuff, but also for integrating to Google Cloud, a whole bunch of different things in there. And they're things that a lot of the ones that are in Google's ones, they're just simple things that you often forget how to do. Now, things like pandas load CSV and stuff like that, probably nowadays, not as needed as in the past, because this brings us to the next sort of advanced feature. And this is the whole sort of generate with AI or Colab AI. I don't know if this is available everywhere in the world. I know it's available most places in the world now. Google released this sort of mid to late last year. And the idea here is that you can basically have it where you can put in a prompt and you can ask it, okay, how do I, for example, something like this where I can chat to it. So it's basically like a GitHub Copilot in here. And at any point, I can copy this or I can just insert this. And you see, when I insert it, I basically get it in here. So it is like an on-the-fly snippet maker, right? It is the way that I use this. There are two ways to use it. You can use it with this sort of chat example here that we've got going here, or you can just come in here and do it in here. So for example, I might say, okay, so I say something like, write me a loop that iterates through a list called items and prints each item. And you can see that once I basically press enter, that will just put this in and do it. Now it'll put in a comment for the prompt that I used, which can be useful. It'll give us four different examples so that we can see. Now, in this case, it's such an easy thing that the examples are not very different, but often the examples will be different. That's something that you can kind of use in there as well. And then once we've accepted this, we can just press close over here. And then now it's just become like a normal code cell in here. If I want to delete the prompt, I can go and delete the prompt in here. So this can be really useful when you've got a package or something, you're not really 100% sure how to use it. You just want to ask it a quick question. Hey, write me something that does this or that checks that. Write me a unit test, that kind of thing. So I'd say Colab AI is definitely worth checking out. It is available both in the free version of Colab and the paid version of Colab in different parts of the world. I'm not sure currently what the state of rolling that out is. Okay, so another advanced sort of Colab feature I wanted to show you is how you can actually integrate Colab with Google Cloud. So if you're not a Google Cloud user, this probably is not going to apply to you. But if you are, there's some nice things that you can do in here. So what I'll do is come into the marketplace, and if I come in here and type in Colab, you'll see that, okay, I can select Colab in here. Now, there's also another version of Colab called Colab Enterprise. I'm not actually going to go through that in this video. That's kind of built into Vertex AI. So maybe in the future, we can sort of look at that. All right. So what I want to do is I want to come in here and spin up a custom machine for Colab. So if I click launch, you'll see that I go into this part here where I can select what exactly it is that I want. So let's say I want something with four NVIDIA T4s in here. So I'm just going to set up Colab one, let's say T4s, or let's say four T4s, right, for this. Now, I basically select the zone. I can select what sort of compute I want the VM to be, et cetera. And the idea here is that I'm using something that I'm actually telling it what kind of VM I want to do this. Now I can then set up more things about the disk. I can, you know, allocate more disk size and stuff like that. So if you've seen me do videos where I have like multiple A100s in Colab, one of the ways to do that is through this, where I can basically just specify that I want multiple GPUs in here. All right. Once I've got that, I'm going to basically just click deploy, and you'll see that it's going to take a while to actually spin up that machine and give us an instance for this. So this will normally take a few minutes, you know, while it's actually spinning up. Okay, and then after it's set up, you'll basically see that we've got the tick here, and you'll see that now we can connect to the VM with Colab. So if I click this, it's going to open up a new Colab, and I will basically just make a new notebook. Okay, now you can see that I've got my new notebook here, and I can basically mention testing four T4s in here. All right, now when I connect to this, you'll see that I'm actually connecting to this instance. Now, I'll basically hide the actual project name, but you'll be able to see that I'm in zone US1B here. I've got my instance there. I just click connect. And what it will do is basically connect to that VM that I spun up and basically using this. So I'm not going to really do anything with this, but let's just see if I do NVIDIA SMI, rather than seeing one T4, I should be seeing four of them. And sure enough, you can see now I've got four T4s set up there. So if I wanted to do a training with multiple GPUs and stuff like that, this allows me to easily set it up so I can do the training with multiple GPUs in here. And it doesn't even have to be GPUs. We could have set up a TPU pod slice in here and stuff like that as well. This is one of the things that we can look at in here. Now, one of the issues, if you are trying to basically get GPUs, getting allocations of GPUs, or at least A100s, etc., can be quite challenging for certain regions. So you want to play around with getting it set up and being able to do this. But here you can see now I've basically got a custom Colab, where I've got all the advantages of my normal Colab. I've got my secrets in here. I've got my snippets. I've got all the other things. But I'm using a custom VM at the back end, where if I wanted a VM with a lot of RAM or with multiple GPUs like this, I can easily do this and go through it. So that's another one of the advanced features that you can look at doing with Colab. So the next thing that I want to talk about is actually a Chrome extension. So you can't actually see my extensions in the window here, but this is the one that I'm running. So this is basically opening Colab. And the idea here is that anytime that you find a notebook in GitHub, you can press this extension and it will open it up as if it's a Colab. So you will still have to install like packages and stuff like that, but it makes it very easy to basically get things out. So an example of this here, you can see I've come into the Google Cloud Platform Generative AI. They've got a number of IPython notebooks here that we know that, okay, these can load up. Now, Google themselves will generally put a link to a Colab in here. So you'll see something like this where it's got running Colab, but a lot of people won't. And so you can see that if we've got something like this, we can just come up here and open this in Colab. And what it will do is it basically, you can open any notebook in Colab by just changing the pathway, and then it will basically open it up. So you can see that from this, it just takes the /GitHub/the repo name, etc., and puts this all in there. And now we've got it loaded up. We could use it just like a normal Colab in here. So this I find often very useful for just quickly getting a nice, simple way to basically get a notebook that someone's put a notebook in their repo or something like that, and I want to check it out. I can just load it up here. And then once it's here, I can just copy it to Drive, and I've got my own copy of it for me to mess around with, etc. All right, so that covers most of the advanced ones. The last ones are some fun ones. And these were originally, I think, April Fool's Day kind of things. These are the various modes that you can have for running this, and you'll see that you then get different characters being corgis, cats, and Google has a very weird thing about crabs. They've added crabs to this as well. Can be quite humorous at times. We can see there's the cute cat up there. The other one is power, which you can basically set to do, I think, some visual effects or something. Honestly, I haven't played with that one that long. But these different modes are actually quite fun for getting kids interested in coding and stuff like that. I found this to be quite cool in here. So I think I'll leave it there. And that can be one of the advanced features as we see all these characters running across Intro to Gemini Pro in here. Hopefully you found some things in here useful. I do find it very easy for just sketching out ideas quickly on this. Don't forget, as always, you can basically save the code in Python. And by basically downloading it, you can just download an IPython notebook. You can download just the Python, bring it into VS Code and stuff like that. So if I'm doing stuff for production, I would normally start out here, then move across to VS Code for a lot of these kinds of things. Anyway, as always, if you've got any questions, etc., put them in the comments below. Let me know if there's any tips for Colab that I've missed. Please let me know. Always interested to see new and cool sort of Colab tips and ways that people use it out there. And of course, if you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.